morning, good night, or good evening. It depends where you are. My name is Vitor Monteiro, and I'm here to present the paper, a full analysis of a non-isolated three-level DC-DC converter integrated in the bipolar DC power grid. The paper, the other co-authors are Cátia Oliveira and Professor João Luís Afonso. We are from the University of Minho, the Group of Energy and Power Electronics, which is an integrated group of the research, Algorithmic Research Center from University of Minho, as I said. But the main idea is to introduce this paper with the classical three-level DC-DC converter. But the main objective of this paper is just to analyze its operation during the fault analysis. So, in terms of introduction, DC power grids present significant advantage over AC power grids. There are also disadvantages, but from our point of view, there are very, very relevant advantages of DC power grids. And the future can be performed based on DC grids. Some of such advantages are related with the controllability, the absence of harmonic currents, as well as reactive power. Additionally, taking into account that the renewables and energy storage systems operate natively in DC, the DC grids will facilitate the interface of renewables as well as storage systems to directly in DC. The DC grids can be unipolar or bipolar. It depends of the architecture of the grid, which is imposed by the power converters, and the possibility of a DC grid bipolar with the three wires can provide more flexibility, reliability, and transmission capacity. So, however, take into account that there are problems that can occur, failures in the wires, for instance, or in the power converter. It is necessary to perform an analysis for the different situations and to analyze how the converter can deal with such failure. Thus, this paper is focused on these topics: the fault analysis of a non-isolated three-level DC-DC converter with a specific situation to consider the interface of the PV panels. So, in terms of converter, this is the topology that was considered. This is the converter. The interface of PV panels and in the right side, the three-wire DC grid. The grid has three wires. The converter can operate to inject energy into the grid. It's possible to control the converter to operate with an algorithm of maximum power point extraction from the renewables. And an advantage of this topology is the possibility to operate with a multi-level functionality, as well as the possibility to be controlled in an interleaved-based strategy, where the ripple of the current in the inductors here will have a ripple with a frequency that corresponds to the double of the switching frequency of each switching device. So in terms of topology, it can be used to interface the grid with the three wires, with a three-wire grid. It operates like a similar converter to interface renewables, where the main advantage is in fact the possibility to operate at the three voltage levels. The analysis of the paper will consist in considering that occurs a failures in the grid, for instance, supposing that occurs a failure in the positive wire, how the converter operates, how it deals with such failure. So the main idea is to consider such operations. In this case, is present the converter under a failure in the positive wire. When I push the failure in the positive wire, the converter is controlled in this way with the switching device, only with these switching devices, to extract the maximum power from the renewable. Or this, of course, this is the two situations during with a positive when I push the failure in the positive wire. This is the two conditions A and B to operate as a boost converter. This situation is related with the situation of a failure in the neutral wire when occurs a failure in the neutral wire. For the case A and for the case B, the two distinct situations of operation of the converter to operate as a boost converter, and the last one when occurs a failure in the negative wire. It is possible to see the two situations for the case A and to the case B. It's possible to see that it also operates during the in boost mode. In the three situations, it operates a boost in boost mode. However, with all the features that the converter can operate. So this slide shows some of the obtained results. The operation of the converter in normal conditions for a reference current of 10 amps, it is possible to see that the current follows perfectly the reference of 10 amperes, and it is possible to see that the current has the double of the switching frequency of the switching devices, of each switching device. It's possible to see that the voltage produced by the converter, the voltage of the converter, the voltage one of the converter and the voltage two of the converter. And these are the pulse width modulation of the different switching devices. For S1, D1, S2, D2. This is for the switching devices, and this is for the diodes. This is a situation in normal and fault conditions in the positive wire. In the first stage, it is possible to see the first stage during the normal operation and then during the failure. It is possible to see that of course, during the normal situation, there are no problems, and the converter operates like the previous situation. In this second case, when occurs a failure, it is possible to see that the current also follows its reference. However, the ripple is higher than the previous situation. This is can be a critical situation or not, it depends. But for instance, to extract the maximum power from the PV panels, it's not a critical point. Since the converter will also extract the maximum power from the renewable. The difference is that the ripple will have a higher ripple. It's possible to see that the switching device one will be almost always on. The current in the diode will be to zero and is switched in the switching device number two. This is a situation in normal and fault conditions in the neutral wire. It is possible to see a situation quite similar to the previous one. In normal operation, it operates correctly. And in the fault analysis, the current also follows its reference, however, with a higher switching frequency. And additionally, it's possible to see that the ripple has a frequency that does not correspond to the double of the switching frequency, but it is equal to the switching frequency, which is also an disadvantage. But as I said, it is important to highlight that the converter can extract the maximum power from the renewables. That is the most important point. see the situation normal and fault conditions in the negative wire, the situation is equal to the previous one. The ripple, the current will follow its reference. The ripple will be higher, and the frequency will be reduced to half compared with the traditional situation. This slide shows a transient state of the converter normal conditions to verify that it can follow its reference perfectly. It's possible to see that the current the reference is in the value of 10, and then it is reduced to 8, and the current also follows its reference normally in few microseconds. This is a detail of a transient state in the presence of a failure. It is possible to see that occurs a failure. The situation is occurs a failure, okay, and then it was changed the reference, and it is possible to see that even in the fault conditions, the converter can follow its reference with the transient state. This is the same situation, transient state, but during the failure in the neutral wire, it is possible to see that the current always follows its reference, even with a failure in the neutral wire. And the same situation occurs for the failure in the negative wire, where it is possible to see that the current follows its reference, even with the failure in the wire. So, in terms of conclusions, a three-level DC-DC converter is analyzed in normal and fault conditions, connected to a DC power grid with a three-wire. It was a characteristic that was considered in the scope of this paper, this type of DC grid. The three-level converter aims to interface the PV panels with the DC. The DC grid, and it is possible to see that it works perfectly in such situations, in normal conditions and in transient state. The results were compared in the presence of a failure, individual, in the positive, neutral, and negative wires of the DC grid to analyze the difference between the type of failures that occurs in the negative, positive, or neutral wire. And even considering the presence of failures in the grid, the current from the PV panels follows the reference. And even considering the failure situations, the converter can extract the maximum power, because it was proven that it can be adapted according to the reference that is established. However, the current presents a higher ripple. And the future of having the double of the switching frequency is no longer possible, and such characteristic is also not considered is not verified in the fault conditions. Can be critical or not, depends the situation, but to interface PV panels, it can operate perfectly, it can follow the reference, it can be adapted according to transient state of the reference, which is the most important point of the converter during the fault conditions. It is important to highlight that the traditional boost converter with a two-wire DC grid, if occurs a failure, in one of the wires, the maximum power will be not extracted from the renewables. So, this converter has a set of very important advantages, and even more considering that it can operate during fault in the DC grid. So the converter presents very, very good results in normal and fault conditions, and without compromising the power extraction from the PV panels, which are the most important points that should be highlighted. So, thank you very much for the attention. If you have any doubt or just for curiosity, please feel free to contact us. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.